All right, here we go. Thank the Lord. Okay, it looks like they're both going to rush for the Agony. Psychic, he's going to rush for the center, it seems. But it looks like Eos, Alistar, he's going to rush for the melee building. Go, go, go. Rush, rush, rush. Run, Forest, run. And they're going to send their Cav. He is going to send two Yari Cav units to secure that melee dojo, as I like to call it, because it increases all the stats of every unit, basically. That's what everybody reminded me on YouTube. It increases all melee stats for all units, not just swords. So since his opponent is going to neglect the shrine, I'm sure he's going to take that quite easily, but he brought a lot of Cav, so I don't think that melee dojo is going to go without a fight. He is going to go for the hill around that with his Naginata attendant. That is Agony Psychic I'm talking about. And what is happening? They're each sending one Naginata attendant for those key buildings. Let's see the stats of these units. Alistar's general is kind of mixed between melee and leadership. I don't see bow or nothing, so I think he's just leadership. Psychic, where's his gen? There he is. I guess the same thing. He is a 7-star, so I guess his general is lacking on some traits, but I'm pretty sure he's leadership. He did bring a lot of Yari Ash as well, and a lot of Lone Swords, so this is going to be very risky to do, just Ashgar army. And it looks like Eos, Alistar, he's going to try and start the Cav fight. I don't agree with this. I mean, he has only one Yari Cav unit, and he's going to pull away. I mean, he was going to bring himself into an open engagement against three Cav units, so that really wasn't going to be that smart of a move. So he is going to pull out. He is using the spread out formation with his Yari Cav. I don't agree with that either. It might decrease their charge bonus that Yari Cav devastates other Cav with. So he did secure the Sword Dojo, so if I was him, I would get in Agony Psychic's face right now before he captures that shrine. Maybe he should have brought an upgraded Naginata attendant to at least kill the other Naginata, just trying to secure that shrine. Just killing that off would force Agony Psychic to send another unit, maybe dismount a Cav unit, and that's one less unit you'll have to worry about. But it looks like, yeah, I think Agony is going to charge that Naginata attendant with his own, and this is the only action I see so far between Naginata attendants. But he did bring Bocav, so he is going to try and harass his opponent's forces, but Yari Cav are so much faster than these Bocav, so you need to really protect them, and he's going to do that with a Naginata Samurai. Psychic still has that Naginata attendant. If I were Alistar, I would at least kill that one unit, or... And those Bokev are really going to annoy him, so he's going to stick in the forest. He's going to stay in there, and he is going to try and get in his opponent's face. Now, that Naginata attendant of... Alistar? Yeah, he is about to rout. That's the only real damage going on so far. Yeah, recharged by Yari Cav. That is it for that Naginata attendant, and they are all alone. No one to wish him farewell or nothing, so that unit is dead, and he might chase it off the field. Yeah, that's at least what I would do, because I chase riding units all the time. Moving through the fours, yeah. And he is dressed as the Takeda, so I guess he's a fan of them. But he didn't bring as much Cav as I thought he would be. And look, Cav engagement going on right now. And these Bocav are dead. No use trying to run away, man. I mean, those Yari Cav are so much faster. And these are two easy kills for Alistar. And Psychic is going to send his Naginata Warrior Monk. Cavalry. And they are pretty... their stats are really good. And those Yari Cav really didn't give off any charge against them, so maybe he needs to pull out. That's what he's doing right now. There we go. He did that because Psychic did send a Naginata Samurai to help him in that engagement. There's more maneuvers happening. Psychic is going to try and flank around with his Yari Cav. He is taking the Yari Cav he had on the opposite side of the field, and he's going to try and position him on the other flank where he's having difficulty breaking through Alistar. And Alistar is just going to keep up the pressure, and then he's going to start the melee engagements now at the very center. And it looks like Psychic is going to try and pull a yellow. He's going to use the Yari Ash line and Spear Wall formation with his leadership gen. He will drop down a Stand and Fight, probably. But Alistar is just going to break on through. He's going to keep on going down the line. He's not going to go and sustain main and blob up just against his Yari Ash. He's going to keep on going down the line and start the engagement with those Lone Swords, hopefully. And he dropped down Rally, but I think Second is gonna, oh no, he just used Rally. I thought he was gonna save it up for the, bigger part of the battle, but I can't tell who might win. He does have the Sword Dojo, but the Agony Psychic does have the Shrine as well, and those Ashigaru need those, their morale increase, so I can't tell who will win in this fight. Maybe if, Psychic gets his, Superior Cav and crashes into the back of those infantry, which he is doing right now with his Yuri Cav, he will rout the entire line of Alisar, but there's many small engagements happening all around the field as well. Alisar is just trying to chase away this Cav with his Naginata attendants and Yari Ash on the flank, so that's other small engagements you can't really ignore at the moment. But I think this is going to go in Agony's favor because he has the Cav superiority, and he could just as easily use two of his Cav units to keep on using Hammer and Anvil on that line. But if Alisar just keeps on going through, kills off these units, and kills off Agony's general, then he's going to be in really big trouble, and he needs to do this now. Agony is sending a Naginata Samurai against his general, and he can't stop that with just a Naginata Samurai, so his general is just as good as dead. But Agony still has a Yari Cav, and he could just as easily keep on Hammer and Anvil the back of these units that are trying to kill off his general right now. If I were him, I would just send my Tsubu Warrior Monk, and then let my general run away. But Alisar has broken the main body of Agony's infantry here, but Agony still has a substantial force, and he could just as easily avoid some fights and just kill off unit at a time of Alisar. He is taking a Yari Cav, and he is attacking the back of that Naginata attendant and his general. So if he just as easily kills his general, he could just as easily end this, and it might go in his favor as well. But I can't tell. It's going back and forth. The power bar says Alisar is winning, and if he has any spear units left, then I think he could just as easily take out those Cav units of Agony. And I am seeing the word easily like 20 times in a row. Yeah, not that much vocabulary going on here, but the battle is still continuing. It is getting kind of laggy, so many bodies all over the place, but Alisar is continuing the pressure. He is not going to slow down. The rally has faded, and I think his general just died or something because his units are starting to waver and rout. So if I were Agony, I would just wait this out, keep some units back. He is keeping the Bocav back, but I think he's winning the battle. Chain routing, friends routing nearby. Friendly units riding nearby, so that's going to lower the morale even further. So yeah, Agony has taken the first match. That is really clear to see already. And plus he has that Bocav, and having Bocav in the late game is really important. And this would be really awkward if Alisar ended up winning, but I'm pretty sure he lost. Because Agony still has Cav, and his opponent has nothing but, he still has that Naginata attendant, but that's really nothing. He has that Nodachi.
He has a Walker Raider that's almost full, but it's a bit away.
Yeah, that is far away, but he still has Cav, he could just Hammer and Anvil it. I can't tell who's gonna win. He still has that Naginata Samurai. All he needs to do is really mop up these last two units, and I think that'll be enough. Yeah, that's it. Quiddium saying Agony's gonna lose, but I really can't tell. I mean, any unit can rout instantly. Yeah, the morale is back. Yeah, Agony. God damn, I gotta retract what I just said, and I just said he might be winning. Shows you what I know, people. But I mean, anything can happen. Units have routed automatically before. It could look like you're winning at one point, and then you lose. But, see, he routed these units, this Naginata attendant, and he could just as easily pepper down that Wako Raider and then salt him and saute him later on with his Naginata Samurai. But he is just going to run away. He's going to run to the shrine. He could take that away from... No, he's going to go to the shrine, but if I were him, I would... It's the Sword Jojo, really, that's helping this Wako Raider. So maybe if he sent his Naginata Samurai to... the Sword Dojo, but Alisar can just as easily go to the Shrine, but I guess the Shrine is most important in the late game. So Agony could just annoy him with the Bocav wait until he ran out of missiles and just used hammer and anvil while he's attacking the front of this Naginata Samurai. That Naginata Samurai needs to, like, chill and get refreshed. Because this Waco Raider is just going to whoop them in melee because they pretty much have full number. They're down to 94. And the Sword Jojo is in their favor, so their attack is like 21, 13 morale, melee defense is 11, charge bonus 29, armor is 3, so they would just devastate that Naginata Samurai. He needs to get that Bokav even closer, like try and scare that unit away from that Naginata Samurai or something, because it will just catch up, and that will be like the only unit standing for Agony. I'm pretty sure if that infantry unit of Agony routes or something, then that Bokav will route as well. But this match was really close. I mean, you never expect these kind of matches to get this close before.
I will laugh if LSR actually... I will laugh if your prediction isn't true.
I don't know why he sent in that Bokev. I think it's going to be in Alistar's favor because that Waco Raider just got charged with the Bokev in a forest, and that minimizes the charge of cavalry. So if that Bokev routes, yep, as it did, then all he needs to do is close the distance and kill off his Naginata Samurai. It depends on, I guess, whoever's fresh, not tired, and has the morale as high as it can be, they'll win. But this Waco Raider might win. Yeah, they won. So Alistar is going to take game number one, and we got to expect at least two more matches after this. GG between these two players.
Yeah, that was an epic match. I never really knew who would win until the very last moment.
My predictions suck.